We're on the party train. Choo-choo! This week, I'm Style with a Smile. Welcome to Style with a Smile. I'm your host, Jonathan Fong. Do you know what the hottest trend in parties right now is? It's bunting. Bunting. Now, I'm not talking about the bunting that you do in baseball, like I'm such a big jock or anything like that. No, I'm talking about those banners that you see at parties where they hang these little flags on them. So I'm giving my twist on it, and I've made these little bunting triangles that are actually little photo frames as well. So your bunting is a series of picture frames. Now, how cool is that? We're gonna make our bunting today with some scrapbook paper because I'm gonna make our bunting today with scrapbook paper because, I love to use scrapbook paper. It comes in all those, great colors and patterns. The first thing we'll do is cut this scrapbook paper in half. And we'll just use this one strip here. Next, I wanna fold this piece of paper in half. And after it's folded, cut it into a triangle. And here we have our cute little flag that's gonna go in our bunting. Now I want to put a little hole here that's gonna make up our picture frame. But as you know, it's hard to punch a hole in the middle of the page with most hole punchers. But I found this great hole puncher from Fisker. However, I found this great punch from Fisker's and it punches anywhere on the page. So let me show you how fun this is to do. These are the three components of the anywhere punch. So I just put my piece of paper here where I want to punch it. And this is magnetized, so it fits right on top of there and fits really securely. And then this part actually does the punching. So I press down and look at that. I just love when that turns out. Now with the hole punched here, it already makes a great photo frame, but what I want to do is actually create a little border around this hole so that it really highlights the photo a little bit better. And what I've done actually is created a little flower and then I'm going to punch a hole in that flower. And I'm just lining it up to make sure I don't cut any of the petals off. And wait till you see this. Look at that. A perfect little border for our flag. And it'll go just like that. So let me glue that on. Next, we want to punch two holes in the back flap. So I'm using a regular hole punch, and this is where the ribbon is going to go through. So it will just go right through these holes. Of course, you can use regular photographs, but I printed these photographs on sticker paper because it'll really make it easy to apply to the frame. So I'll just slide the picture in the back. And there it goes. Isn't that cute? Now I'm going to seal the edges now. See how they're flapping up? We don't want that. So I'm just going to seal the edges with some double stick tape. And we're finished with our bunting. Look how adorable this looks. I made this bunting for my niece Charlotte's 1-year birthday that's coming up. I can't make it to the party, so I'm gonna send this to her. It's really great having me as an uncle. I hope these kids realize how lucky they are. Bunting adds a festive touch to any party. And when you turn your bunting into photo frames, it gives it a really nice personalized touch. So here's a strange question. If Matt Damon had bunting, would it be Goodwill Bunting?